Well, look, I've been waiting to do this for a long time. Man, probably almost 10 years. See, we started the Women's Center on April the 23rd of the year 2002. 10 years. Doesn't seem like it's been that long. You know, everybody said that when you start a Women's Center, it was going to be more difficult. That's not exactly what they said. It was a lot worse than that. But it must not have been too bad because we've been doing it 10 years. And it only seems like 7.5 or something. Amen. But I've been wanting to do this for a long time. We are having a Fresh Start graduation. But we're not having a Fresh Start men's graduation. Why? Because women are more special than men. So we are going to have a Fresh Start Women's Center graduation. Let's go with it. All right. Got it. First time ever. That's right. So here we go. We have an awesome group of young ladies that are going to do great things that we've been able to see. I think every one of these ladies have some kind of involvement with us. They all been helping. They all been working. They've done great. And the first one is Miss Ashley Putman. Ashley has been part of our lives for a long time through her family and knowing her family for a long time. And we are excited to see what God's going to continue to do from here. Amen. Amen. All right. All right. Miss Ree Thibodeau's next. Tell you, getting to know Ree and to see what God's done in her life and just how much she's grown, how much of a leader she is. And we'll be performing her wedding ceremony before long to one of our Fresh Start graduates, Kyle. Amen. Amen. So we'll enjoy doing that too. All right, next is Miss Camille Watts. Hey, stand right here for just a second. Oh, I do want to say this because a lot of people don't understand, mainly because you look this way and also because she is a little shorter. But Camille has been serving in our sound booth for many, many weeks now. Amen. The big Valentine's Day deal that we had, she came up here days early and started decorating, getting ready for that, and has been just a big part behind the scenes. But I heard a rumor. You know how rumors are. You never know. But I heard a rumor that she's trying out for the praise team on stage real soon. Amen. So you may be seeing Miss Camille on stage. Good to see you, girl. All right. And this young lady next has been one of my favorites since she was 14 years old, Miss Ashley Rosin.
My name is Rhiannon Thibodeau. I'm 22 years old and I'm from South Louisiana. For years, I struggled with addiction and a self-destructive lifestyle. Little did I know, these struggles were just symptoms of the deep roots to my toxic ways. Unforgiveness, selfishness, and the feeling of unworthiness flooded my life and I was drowning. After a few times in jail, a growing rap sheet, and separation from my family, I knew there had to be something more. I prayed for change and God answered with fresh start. After weeks of being obedient, restoration and healing started filling up the holes in my life. Things became clear and I finally knew the truth. By that truth, I've been set free from my old life. God makes all things new. I've been completely transformed and I've learned how to rejoice in serving and giving. The growth in me is tremendous and the peace in me is unfathomable. I'm all He says I am every day. My plan is to continue to shine and be a light to everybody back down south to show them what God can do and that through Him nothing is impossible. Proverbs 14:1 says, "The wise woman builds her house, but with her own hands the foolish one tears hers down." I'm ready to build my life with God as a centerpiece. So thank you for a start and my sisters in Christ. Now I can live my blessed life. All praise be to God.
My name is Camille Watts. I'm 22 years old and I was born in Manila, Philippines when I was shy of 3 weeks old. I was adopted into a family from Doha, Louisiana. In my life, I have struggled with abandonment, self-confidence, and broken relationships. I was trapped in a simple life and I knew right away that I needed help. That's when I heard about Fresh Start. When I walked through the doors, I was broken and scared. I didn't know what to expect. I also didn't know God. Now I have a relationship with God and I know that He will always be there for me. I am thankful for many blessings He has given me and He called me to share my light with others. I want to thank the staff at Fresh Start for all they've done for me, to my parents for supporting me through the bad and good, and for never giving up on me. But most of all, I want to thank God for never leaving me and strengthening me to be the woman of God He's called me to be. For saving my life and continuing to open doors for my life, I know now there's nothing He can't do. There are no limits to life, and wherever I go, I will be a light to so many people. Philippians 3:13 says, "I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining towards what is ahead. As I'm made new in His love, I will always be encouraged to look at the goodness that lies ahead of me. It just keeps getting better and better. Thank you."
My name is Ashley Putman, and I'm from Oak Grove, Louisiana. When I entered the doors at Fresh Start, I was at the lowest part of my life. I was broken, full of shame, and had low self-esteem. I was a slave to my own sin. After burying my 17-year-old son, Chandler, I had lost all hope in my life. I felt I had no reason to live. But God quickly showed me the plans He has for me and my own are nothing of the same. The truth is, we are all flawed as sinful creatures, and we wish we could become real without uncomfortable things happening to us. But life isn't like that. Life is a process of growth and change as God uses our experience in hard times to draw close to Him, to refine our faith and make us more like Jesus. I had to learn that even I wasn't beyond His reach and nothing is impossible without Him. His capacity for restoring life is far beyond our understanding. I saw restoration for mine and my children's life quickly transpire. I've been healed from all affliction and my thought process has been transformed. Galatians 5:1 says, "It is freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery." I have been released and I'm no longer enslaved. God's plan for me is to be a voice for those who feel they don't have one, to be an advocate for mothers who lost their children to hate, to be a woman of God in all that I do on every occasion, to let others know not to miss the blessing God has for us, by understanding He can use each of us and our story to help someone else. I want to thank Fresh Start for helping save my life, all the staff for accepting me with open arms, just as I was, and never giving up on me, for showing me a new way to live, for my sisters in Christ for loving me, always being there, and showing me how powerful our prayers really are. Thank you to my family for always believing in me and for all of your support. And lastly, thank you, God, for never leaving me. Thank you for showing me how to love myself and that forgiveness is the key to all of our blessings.
My name is Ashley Rawson, and I'm from Wesleyan, Louisiana. I've struggled with addiction in my life. I lost myself very quickly, and I've become someone I didn't know, love, or trust. I lost my identity as a wife, mother, and daughter, but most importantly, my true identity in Christ. I was tired and had lost all hope. Every piece to my life was broken. When I entered the doors of Fresh Start, I was scared, angry, and shameful. But I was quickly surrounded with love. I began to work on myself. I now have a newfound intimate relationship with my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I no longer carry the burdens of my past. I stand firm in the Word of God. God's promise to me is Jeremiah 29:11. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you. I see a bright future for myself and my family. I would like to give thanks to Fresh Start staff for guiding me through this journey. To all my sisters in Christ for holding my hands and showing me love. To my amazing family for all their love and support, for never giving up on me, and for always believing in me. And most importantly, I give all praise to God for His grace and mercy, but most of all, His never-ending love.